I'm Sucheta, a conscious parenting expert. Today we are going to talk about a golden child syndrome. Now, this we all prefer to have one or two kids. You know, there are two motives for having one or two kids. The first motive is the cost of living, schooling, and everything has increased. So it becomes a financially burdensome to have more than one kids. And the second reason is that each and every parents want to give the best to their child. When I took a decision to have only one child, that was on my mind that I want to focus my attention to, because I was working, I thought that one child I can focus and do my best job as a parent. All of you also must be having the same intention to have one or two kids. We provide them the best care we can afford and we can give. We send them to the best school which is available. We try to provide them the love and care they should get. But in this process, nowadays I have observed a different twist in the tale. What is that twist? That there are lots of cases of relationship failure and a problem like depression, anxiety disorder is increasing among adults, this young adult, because of this golden child syndrome. It does not arise because of lack of love, but it arises because of the intensity of love and care provided by their parents. Since there is only one or two kids, we focus all our attention on the child and we smother that child with care and love. We shower praise on that child that you are beautiful, you are talented, you are intelligent. There are several people in the family. There are parents, mother, father, grandparents, extended family. Everyone showers praise on that child, which the child should get. But in this case, many parents forget that they are showering the child with lots of expectations that you are very intelligent, you are very beautiful, you can sing, you can swim, you can dance. So what is happening here? That child is burdened with the expectations of their parents, which might not be his. He might not be interested in those qualities. So, since being young, he is not aware what he wants. So he starts believing that whatever the parents' expectations are his expectations. And I also made the same mistake. You know, we mask our manipulation with kindness. We try to manipulate our child with love and we tell them that, you know, this dance class is good and this swimming is very good. You know, you should go, you should do this, you are talented. So child also start believing that, yes, I am very beautiful, I am very intelligent, I am very confident. I have been born in this world to create a history, to be a phenomenal person. And what happens when he goes in an actual world where he has to perform, where he has to show result, where he has to interact with several people on a day-to-day basis? A 4-year, 5-year-old kid, when he goes to the class, he has to write A 10 times, 4 times, and he has been told that he can do it, so he tries to do it. And when he can't do it, he feels inadequate. this happens at all the different ages, at all the different places. Take example of a 16-year-old boy who has to appear for his examination, qualifying examination. All these years he has been told that he is very good and he has to perform. So when he tries to perform and is not able to, you know, he breaks down. These children who with a golden child syndrome suffers at two level. You know, overtly they show that they are super confident, but it's like an iceberg. They are filled with insecurity, which makes their hollow inside. They are filled with anxiety, and such children face a lot of trouble in later age. And a parent of such golden child syndrome keep on oscillating between two feelings. You know, they feel that their child is super special. So, you know, the 50-60% they are in that syndrome, that my child is the best than anyone else's. And when the child does not perform or not able to show result, they shift to that 40% of despair and anxiety. And sometimes they pass on that anxiety, stress to the child, further killing the child's confidence. Here a conscious parenting comes into the picture. Why conscious parenting is so important? Because it allows child a freedom to be what he is. It allows child to be ordinary. It allows child to be what he wants to be. There is no manipulation involved from the parents' side of you. There is no expectations. There is no unhealthy expectations burdened on the child. So today's need is conscious parenting. In conscious parenting, there is a combination of Eastern and Western philosophy. It has been profoundly propagated by several thinkers like Rabindranath Tagore. You have to learn about conscious parenting. And subscribe to my YouTube channel to know more about the conscious parenting and how to avoid the golden child syndrome from the parenting. You have to take care both the sides when you are not doing extremes. And who knows that, you know, the history shows that the ordinary person can also be extraordinary person. You never know. Take care. Have a great day. Ciao.